Wow. Welcome to No Authority Field here in Indica Springs, Colorado, where the munchies are so intense, no one minds paying $30 for nachos, including me, and I'm cheap. Fire up and blast some Zeppelin. It's time for some mile-high football. Yeah, this is going to be a bloody game. The teams are loading their weapons and sharpening their spikes. The Purple Mutant Eaters go up against the Mile High Chronic. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Welcome to MFL Sunday School, where the good playbook teaches it's an eye for no reason, a tooth for an eight ball, and a limb for just looking at me the wrong way. MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow, my partner's Bricks and Bricks Jr. Damn it, these guys flat out want to kill each other today.
Yeah, these are the kind of games families come out to see. It's good for the sport.
You know what I like about this home team is 90% of them were born criminally insane. You can't teach that. And it's first and 10. Boom! Second down and more than the QB would like. First down and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and 10. Ah, the strawberry field's dirty trick. As my mentor Hunter used to say, I don't advocate drugs, alcohol, narcotics, or insanity to anyone, but they've always worked for me. Second down and long. When defensive players go berserk, they've been known. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. One speed, engage! To the races. Look at, oh, there goes the ball. It's a fumble.
Is it still a fumble if his hands are attached to the ball?
Oh, so close, but not today. Does anyone have a rule book? Because that sounds like he's making stuff up.
Do we have a rule book?
He's propping up your chair so you can reach the table without spilling your food, idiot.
Third down, and the defense had enough with this ref and jumps off sides to kill him. You know, Bricks, when the ref is faster than your football team, you've got some serious issues. Third and four. It's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Ho-ho! Crowd's loving it. First down and five. And into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's warming.
Look, guys, I'm supposed to be impartial, but this rep is so dirty. He should be where he's moved to go. They're back on first, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down in a mile. A mix of tiger blood, shark blood, and internet comments. Roid rage brings out the worst in anyone. And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. The defense has the receivers covered well. That's a 3-yard gain on that pass. Second down and 7. Third down and long. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
There aren't too many players that kids can look up to at home. I'm glad one. Oh, nice hit. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. I'm going to say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Second down and 7. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. And that'll bring up third down and 7. Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You got to keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You got to make that catch.
Oh, boy, they're going for it. This could get uglier than the baby result.
Hey, didn't your mother ever tell you don't run with a chainsaw? When skeletons make it to the end zone in one piece, that's always cause for celebration. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't abroad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. Man, what a hit that was. And that'll bring up second and 1. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
The teams are all tied up at the end of quarter one. We'll be right back. First down and 1. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Oh, man. You know, they train those things to eat only visiting players. But when they're hungry, they'll eat anything.
Yeah, sometimes I eat my toenails.
And it's first and 10. Man, guys like a freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down. And it's first and 10. And he rumbles for 9 on that play. And that'll bring up second and 1.
I've seen this guy run through a brick wall. He loves pain. First down.
And it's first and 10. And that's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Grim, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
Yeah, they're all in politics, apparently.
Oh, man, he ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
Third and 4. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
Oh, what a brutal hit. Oh. It's first and ten.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. I never looked that good dancing, and I have skin. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
It's first and ten.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
Second down in a mile.
Think you can go toe-to-toe with me? Well, you mistaken, man. You get up my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. I'm gonna wreck it.
And it's first and ten. Huh? And that's a sack. The quarterback has to get rid of the ball there.
Hey, man, nobody can touch me when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, pal?
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. First down! He was not gonna drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And so, that's the two-minute warning. And it's first and ten. And that is caught for a first down. And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. It's first and ten. Perfect pass and a score! Yeah, if there's one thing I can't stand, is a pretty boy who thinks he can dance. Although I am quite a fan of Guts and Finger Fake.
Yeah, oh,
quite the entertainer he is.
I would have to agree with you, Grim.
And they line up for the extra point. It's good. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's first and ten.
Oh,
burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the two-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grin.
And it's first and 10.
First down! I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw them.
Well, that's two timeouts burned. And you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
I'm speaking from experience, Quinn, but it really is hard to do both at the same time. And I have mastered it.
Oh, that's gotta hurt. Snatched in midair by the worm.
They say that the early one gets the mutant, and he got all of him. Oh, look, he's spitting the plates out.
The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry up too?
Grim, can I kill him?
He scores! He earned those points on the heels of an epic run.
Don't call things epic, Grim. Kids aren't gonna think you're cool no matter what you do.
Junior, I don't want kids to think I'm cool. Here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and 10. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. They use their second timeout, but they are running out of time.
A bit pessimistic, don't you think so, Grim?
It's more about building tension, Bricks. That's all we do at this point. And drink this bourbon. Come on, give me that. A nice run for a first down. The quarterback just used his final timeout. Let's see what they come up with on the next play. And it's first and 10. Not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. It's a tie game at the end of quarter two. The teams are deadlocked in a fierce struggle today. We'll be right back with today's halftime show brought to you by Monsatan Industries. Eat their delicious Frankenfood.
Hey, throw in the half. Can you pick me up a Soylent beer?
And they're taking the field for the second half, and we have got a tie score.
Speaking of tie, Grim, me and Hot Wanda, we wanted to try something different, so we tied each other up the other night, and nothing happened because we were both tied up. I don't understand what the big deal is.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And that'll be second and 8 to go. And then catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and 10. 9-yard completion. They are moving the ball now with authority. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. That's a 2-yard pass play, and that's not going to get it done. The offense needs to move the ball upfield. No, they couldn't pick up a 1st down, so now they have to punt. Oh, no good. Now that punter's going to find a cut. They let the punt drop, and it will be down by the defense. And it's 1st and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. Second down and 5. Roid Rage. How do you like your brains? Scrambled or fried? One Roid Rage breakfast special. That's a killer. It was right there and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
3rd down and 5.
Flimsy Lohan's nose hits a mare in Lost Wages, Nevada.
And it's 1st and 10. Oh, he's gone. That's a catch for a 1-yard gain. That's not going to do it, fellas. Second down and 9. And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. Down and 6. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. 3rd grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down and 5. Was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. Third and 4. And a hard run there picks up the 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. It's 1st and 10. Pow! With the brain scrambler. Second and 3. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done.
Yeah!
are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters.
Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. Man, what a hit that was. And it's first and ten. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it, too. Second down and 10. Caught for the first down. That's the end of three, and it's anyone's game. Hang on tight. The fourth quarter is about to begin. And it's first and 10. And he zips that one in there for a touchdown.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and 10. And he picks up 10 on that run. Man, he nearly broke that one open, Bricks.
Yeah, and I nearly married Trim Big Assian. And I nearly did not crap my pants earlier. Nearly as overrated, Grim.
Third down and three. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and 10. I'm surprised no one uses the electric carving
knife.
And it's first and 10. Put on a display there. Touchdown! Now, these penalties have really gotten out of hand, especially since they're fake.
Go to dirty tricks and hit the tag ref. It feels good.
First down and long, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down and forever.
I personally think the ginormous guy is kind
of... Oh, he took a leap and had the ball knocked out. Fumble!
He's got a cape!
With the vicious kill!
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schlong Galaxy phone.
And it's first and 10. More speed, engage!
What are you trying to place, you nerd fan?
And he's off to the races! You know, in alien culture, dancing is a form of battle.
And they celebrated their best citizens by making too many moves about them. It's a fascinating culture.
You know, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
He is fighting for every yard. It's first and 10. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven-baked porta-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
The quarterback passes the ball and it rebounds back.
He can't get rid of it. It's like me and these crabs, Grim.
Yep, the defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick, and the QB is in a heap of trouble now. Third and four. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. First and 10. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And that'll be second down and four.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Picks up 2 yards on the pass.
Then this guy's 6 feet tall. He could just have fallen over and gotten 2 yards.
Third down and three. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
First down and six. 2 minutes left in the game, and we'll be right back after I top off my drink.
Grab me a scotch while you're up.
First down and six. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races.
What? Come on, man. You can't hang with me. You get my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. You understand me?
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and 10. They've used the strawberry fields dirty trick. Those guys don't know which way forward is now. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? Third down, and the punter is warming up. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. It's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and 7. We are all tied up, and we're going to overtime. Go ahead and cancel that quality time with the family and continue to stream at your television. This is going to be great. Rick's overtime is a war with some basic rules. The first touchdown wins the game, but if the team that receives the kickoff gets a field goal, then the other team is allowed a possession too. After that, whomever scores wins. Here comes the kickoff. And it's first and 10. Free and has open field in front of him. He's at the 40. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. First down and 7. Second and 8 to go. And he pounds the ball into the defense, picking up 7. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
The Mile High Chronic lose the game. They battled hard, but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chimp dicks.
Did you just say choking on a bag of chimp dicks?
Yeah.
God, that was beautiful. With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Eagle SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until